IFS Guided Meditation for Being in Self, The Mountain of Your Ideal Life by Aion Farvahar. I wish I could show you the astonishing light of your own being, Hafiz. Hi, this is Aion Farvahar. I'm glad you're here. If it's your first time here, this channel is about self-realization and honoring our life purpose and meaning. If you're interested in these topics, please subscribe and hit the notification bell to stay connected. Today, I would like to invite you to join me for another IFS self-leadership meditation. This meditation does not require prior knowledge of IFS, so you can still try it as an experiential meditation, even if this is your first exposure to IFS. I share two quick introductions here. One helps you understand the goals of this meditation and the metaphoric meaning of its landscape. The other provides the basic ideas behind IFS and how it helps us connect to our purest sense of self, away from everything in our personality that could otherwise define who we are. If you are already familiar with IFS, you may still find these introductions useful. But if you wish, you can jump directly to start of the meditation at any time using the timestamps I have provided in the description below. The goals and landscape of the meditation. This meditation is an extended version of one of my previous IFS meditations linked here. It is designed with two goals in mind. First goal is to help you separate yourself from all your familiar thoughts and feelings, or whatever else that defines your personality. This allows you to create some space inside and experience presence in your purest sense of self, or simply be in self, away from everything that defines who you believe you are. When you are in self, or one with your purest sense of self, you notice a significant shift in your perspectives about yourself and your life. Second goal of this meditation is to invite you to imagine yourself beyond your familiar life and to realize that your life can be far more ideal and inspiring than what it is now. What stands between you and your ideals in life are parts of your personality that have strong beliefs or perspectives about you and what you can or cannot do. If you notice and understand these parts within you, you can help them relax so you can focus on actualizing the ideal life you have always meant to live. Now, it would be helpful to briefly describe our meditation's landscape and its metaphoric meaning, so you can align your imagination with it. Our meditation's landscape consists of a hill, a mountain, and a valley in between. The valley represents your current familiar life with all your daily thoughts and feelings that collectively reflect your current beliefs and perspectives about yourself and your life. The hill is your private inner world, away from all the distractions of life. You can think of it as a spaciousness you experience when meditating. On this hill, you are in your purest sense of self and free from everything in your personality that otherwise defines you. The mountain represents a symbolic world of your ideals in life, or what your life could be in the future. You can only see the mountain when you are on the hill and connected to your purest sense of self. But to climb the mountain, you must go down to the valley and transform your beliefs and perspectives so they can help you achieve your ideals in life. IFS, a paradigm for understanding our minds. Internal Family Systems, or IFS, is an evidence-based psycho-spiritual model pioneered by Dr. Richard C. Schwartz. In simple terms, IFS model describes how our mind operates. We usually experience or express ourselves through feelings, thoughts, and behaviors. In IFS, these are expressions of our distinct sub-personalities, parts of our personality, or simply our parts. For example, if I have some work to do, the doer part of me may be open to get it done. But there could be another part of me that prefers to delay or procrastinate it. These two parts have their own reasons why one wants to get it done and the other rather not. For example, the doer part of me wants to get it done because it does not want to be blamed or shamed as being lazy. The procrastinator part of me wants to delay things because it is aware of other feelings and thoughts deeper in my mind and wants me to unplug from everything so I will be distracted from them. Our feelings, thoughts, and behaviors are expressions of our distinct personality parts. In addition to our parts, we also have access to a source of wisdom within us called Self, with a capital S. Self represents our presence in our purest sense of being, away from all our familiar feelings or thoughts. We can access Self if we manage to see ourselves separated from our personality parts. If it helps, one can view self as our soul or higher mind. In our meditation today, our goal is to first notice our feelings and thoughts as expressed by our personality parts, and then use visualization to externalize and separate from them. Our personality parts can appear in our meditation or visualization as they wish. They may appear as an animal, a sensation, a sign, or an object, etc. Similarly, in our meditation today, you will be invited to first notice your past feelings and thoughts, then visualize them externally as an animal, an object, or as they wish to appear in your meditation. Because you externalize them, you can temporarily separate yourself from them to create space inside and connect to your purest sense of self, or in IFS terms, be in self. The views presented here are based on my personal experience and understanding of the IFS model. For the official background of this model and its application, please see the description below for a link to IFS Institute website. Preparation for meditation. If you're at home and comfortable, consider smudging the room you're in by your favorite scent or aromatic candle. This could be a statement of your intention and respect for this meditation. Sit or lay down somewhere you feel most comfortable. Take a few deep breaths to feel the air entering your lungs, nourishing your body. If it helps, try to close your eyes or soften your gaze to further descend to a state of calmness and presence inside you and away from the world outside. As you're focusing inside, notice what feelings or thoughts are currently present in your mind. Let them know you notice them, but for now, ask them to separate from you to give you some space so you can be more present. As you're creating this space inside you, gather some light and positive energy on top of your head and direct it down to the core of your body to start your meditation shortly. Imagine yourself standing in a valley on the edge of a hill. The valley is covered with fresh green grass, small plants and rock formations, together making it a safe, familiar and comforting place to be. Take a moment to imagine the landscape of this valley exactly the way you picture it to be in your imagination. Now, focus on some of your strongest feelings and thoughts, or certain aspects of your personality that have been with you throughout your life. These could be feelings you have toward yourself, or the way you view the world or others in your life. As you're noticing these feelings or thoughts in your mind, let them know you would like to see them in this valley. Now, one by one, ask them to show themselves to you, either as an animal or any other way they want you to see or sense them. Take your time to make sure you see, sense, or acknowledge all of them as parts of your being, now gathered around you in the valley. Check how you feel toward them. If you feel particularly connected or curious about some of them, let them know that. Also, if you notice a strong feeling toward any of them, ask that feeling to separate from you or join the others in the valley to show itself to you. Let all your parts now gathered around you in the valley, realize you see them as parts of you. And if it feels right, thank them for being there to keep you company in this valley. Now, tell your parts that you would like to go on the top of the hill to spend some alone time by yourself there. See if they're okay staying in the valley while you're gone. Some of them may not be as comfortable waiting there without you. Try to comfort them by letting them know that you're not going too far and will come back to be with them soon. Ask them to give you space so you can spend time with yourself on the top of the hill. Thank all of them for giving you this space and personal time. Leave your parts along with any feelings or thoughts they represent in the valley and start walking up the hill. Notice that this is your personal time to experience yourself, free from all other aspects of your life, now left behind, down in the valley. This is the time for you to experience your purest sense of self. Once you are on the top of the hill, notice the fact that you are there by yourself, away from anything that otherwise defines you. As you're standing on the hill, imagine the core of your body as the axis of your entire being, with the external world being down there in the valley and far from you. Feel this moment of serenity on top of this hill, with your body as the axis of your being in this world, and with you and your purest sense of self now unified as one. Feel your purest self within you. Notice its energy feeding the core of your being. See if you can feel its calm and compassion toward everything. Feel its courage and strength in you. And feel its unconditional love for you. As you feel its energy, notice that self is always here, at the center of your being. At the center of your being, self is in you, and you are in self, as one and inseparable. Take a moment to feel and remember this connection and union. As you are standing on this hill, experiencing self, notice the beautiful mountain across the hill in the other side of the valley. Now that you are in self, the mountain is showing itself to you, inviting your attention and curiosity. The mountain is colorful, limitless, and much taller than the hill you're standing on. It also has a waterfall in its elevation, giving it more life energy. Take a moment to picture this mountain in your imagination, exactly as you want it to look like. As you're imagining it, see this mountain symbolically as your highest ideals in life. If your hill represents a place of serenity for you to be in your purest sense of self, your mountain represents your ideal life, your true destiny, and where you have always meant to go. So imagine it with everything you want to have in there. This is the mountain of your ideals, dreams, and destiny. Check inside to see how you would have felt living on the mountain of your ideals, instead of staying down there in the valley, experiencing your familiar life. You can live your ideal life beyond what you currently experience in the valley. Take a moment to contemplate on this. Self knows more about your destiny than you yourself do. Maybe it is showing you the mountain to help you realize your life does not have to be limited to what you experience in the valley. Self wants you to see the mountain and higher grounds you could venture in life. Now notice that for you to go to the mountain of your ideals in life, you must pass through the valley again. Your personality parts in there may not be open for you to leave the valley, because there represents the only familiar and safe life you have known so far. So, if you really want a more ideal life on the mountain, you need to listen to your parts, understand their concerns, and help them let go of any doubts or negativity about your future. If you stay connected to self as you are now, they will listen to you and will likely transform to support you in this journey. Your parts in the valley may not know about the mountain and how more ideal your life could be. Now start heading down the hill to return to your parts waiting patiently for you in the valley. when you're back in the valley, look around to see what parts, feelings, or thoughts are still present. Invite them to gather around you and thank them for giving you this space so you can spend time by yourself on the hill. Check how you feel toward them now. If you feel differently now, notice whether you feel more connected to or more curious about them, what they do and why they do that. Remember that they're all parts of your being and have been working hard for you for many years to protect you emotionally and keep you safe. Let them know about the mountain on the other side of the valley. Tell them how it looked and let them know how you felt seeing the mountain and what the mountain reminded you of. If the mountain reminded you of your ideals in life, let them know that and the fact that there is more to life than what you and your parts have been experiencing in the valley. If you feel the mountain represents your potentiality and ideals in life, let your parts know how you feel and ask them if they're open to leave their extreme feelings and thoughts behind to help you in actualizing your ideals in life. Also, if you notice doubts or worry in your parts about changing things in your life, let them know you're not going to make any changes until they're fully comfortable. There could be a part of you that has doubts about your ability to transform. There could also be a part who is not open to change because it's worried about you being tired and not ready for it. Notice what other feelings or thoughts show up in your mind when thinking about making positive changes in life toward your ideals. If any, make a note of them and tell them you're open to hear and understand their concerns and will do everything you can to address them. Thank all your parts again. Say your farewells and come back to the room when you're ready. end of meditation. Reflections. Take a deep breath, and when comfortable, open your eyes or break your gaze. But before coming back to the outside world, make a mental note of any feelings or thoughts that you now notice inside you following this meditation. Consider writing a few lines as journal entry to capture what parts, feelings, or thoughts you have noticed the most, and how you felt when experiencing being in self. Please keep in mind that guided meditations like this may not work perfectly the first time. So I would suggest noticing the landscape and the process and repeating it later in your own pace and words. If you have found this meditation inspiring, please like and share it with your like-minded friends. Also, please subscribe to my channel, hit the notification bell, and share your thoughts and comments. Your support is the foundation of this channel and encourages me to create more content in the future. For more information about myself and what I do, please find my bio link in the description below. Blessings.